What's up, YouTube? I have this old VCR. It's a Sony. It's one of the later models. Doesn't mean it was the fancier one, but it's just one from the late 90s or perhaps early 20s, about the time when we start having DVDs. So Sony did still produce a few VHS, VCR actually, the VHS is the cassette. They were still producing, but it was really the last later models, last models, and also this one stopped working on the audio side because they had cheap capacitors. Sony knew this were not meant to be used for many years, so they put cheap parts. The image still works, but the audio, it's gone by now, so it's going to garbage bin. But before I did remove the cover, be aware obviously there is power in there, so don't touch too many things. I still have a cassette inside, and I'll show you how the tape would roll when the thing goes powered and playing. This is going to be normally you shouldn't be touching, but again, just go gently, or just the thing goes to the garbage, doesn't matter. This is the video tape, video head, so that's when you read the video, the image of it. There is another small head here which will erase the video image, because you can actually record with this from your TV or even from another VCR. Also, you have an audio head which is the same as the audio cassettes thing, so it's just magnetic tape, it will just record the sound, or basically over record the sound. Because if you had a tape, this being one of those cassettes, big, heavy, they can all be recorded, and you can choose before between the recording time. The shorter, the better the quality. It's just the speed of the tape that is varying. And also you can record over this as many times as you want. You basically don't have to erase. It's not like digital things. So this being magnetic, you simply have maybe a film on it, and then you want to record another one, just start, press the record button, is going to completely erase, it's going to remagnetize the tape, and it's going to just forget about what was before, just putting new things, new sound, new image. That's how you do it. The more you would record, the lesser the quality. Now I'll show you a few things, because it's very interesting inside. This tape, it's actually sitting under very strong tension inside when it's working. Let's just try to actually just plug the thing into the power outlet, and as soon as I will plug it, see what happens. The thing starts spinning right away. So that's interesting, and actually it will keep spinning. Let's see, or no, I think it does stop. Yeah, it will stop. Okay, so as soon as, let's try to eject the cassette. So this is going to be a perhaps 15 minutes video. I'll just sit back and relax. If I will press eject, the cassette should come out. I'll show in a moment all those little arms, and that's how I pull the cassette. Let's see what this. It's a demo for a Passat that my parents had back in the day. A nice car, perhaps one of the last good Volkswagen made in Europe, actually, that one. You can see the magnetic tape if you want, but it's tricky. You need to press this tiny button to flip back the cover. I'm doing this one hand, so that's the tape. You can touch it, but it's better not. Also, you cannot spin this by hand. Don't force, it's not going to work. It will only spin when you depress something in there, perhaps. So there is all that mechanism that works. The way you push this thing, it will just get in there, and there's going to be quite a few things that move and open this cover and pull the tape. And the tape, you will see, the tape will go like this, will be stretched out on the sides of the head, so it doesn't go around the head. And obviously it's going to be grabbed to touch those other heads. This is the roll, and you will see a few things moving in there. So let's just try to insert the cassette. Basically you can slide it like this. At some point it will fill about here, so there's like one
2 centimeters remaining, you need to put a little bit of pressure on it at that point to be grabbed by the mechanism. And that's how the tape is being trapped, if I can say so. Let's just see once again for the sake of it. So now it's retiring the cassette. I did put eject, I think. Let's see how it does work. The ejecting the cassette. Oh no, that's not eject, that's the power button. Sorry, here's the eject one. Interesting, and now it's closing the cover and it's spitting the thing. Yeah, pretty nice. What's interesting is that whenever you, obviously when you play push play, it will spin the head. If I will do just play on it, perhaps like this. Yeah, so right now it's working. You can see the tape is spinning in there. Counter is going on. And you notice it's not very noisy, but it is noisy. And that's how it was back in the day. So it wasn't quiet, a quiet room with a movie. There was noise from the machine. That's how it was. Basically because you have a small motor, but also because you have bearings on there, so those bearings do make some noise. What's interesting, and I don't recommend you do that on your machine, but I will do on mine because I know I don't care about it, is if I would try to put pressure on the tape, which obviously the tape is spinning, is moving at a fast speed, it's quite under tension. It's interesting. You may think the tape is fragile. It's not exactly fragile. So it does go through some rollers. Does go against the head, the video head, at an angle. That's interesting too. This is a Eraser head, like I'm saying. If I would try to fast forward, let's see for the camera. Let's try fast forward. So this is playback fast forward. So right now the image will advance. I'm not showing you the images just too much to film, but the image will just go fast forward. You can do the same backwards, but also from the play position you can go slow motion, and slow motion is more like frame by frame motion. It wasn't that developed back in the days, but see what it does. Look at the cassette, how it spins when I press the slow motion button. I should perhaps, there you go. That is the slow motion. The image will move slowly for that action scene, but obviously wasn't smooth, and anyway the image was anything but high resolution back then. It's just not. However, I can say that the image of these VCRs, it had some sort of a personality to it. It was more like, sometimes the color would get washy because the tape was old or recorded too many time on it, but it had a character to it. And maybe we are the generation which would expect perfection. We move from 4K TVs to 8K or something like that, from 20 megapixel camera to 30 megapixel. So we're never satisfied in some way, and I think we are just losing character. When you switch to look for perfection, you don't have color in things. You just go to scrap some details, which sometimes is just nice to have imperfection. I think it's same. I did a few videos on a LP turntable machine, which was not full analog but wasn't digital, and is not perfect, but it's, I think, nicer than CDs in my opinion. So this is how it goes. This is how it worked back in the days. This is a technology that was brought to market somewhere in the 70s, perhaps later 70s, and the machine back then were big, and I think also they will eject the cassette on top, and they're very heavy machines. And this would be used up to early 2000, but already in 2000 there were the DVDs coming out, so this was scrapped. So these cassettes were heavy, big, and will keep perhaps one movie on them. Not too expensive though, but it's different than a DVD, obviously, size-wise, physical. One other thing perhaps, and I'm finishing with this, is that you see, if I would play the thing, so right now it's playing, you want to see that little image, cassette spinning, the camera has a little bit trouble, that's digital versus not exactly analog, but it's if you, from playback, you would stop the thing, what's interesting is that this head does not actually stop spinning. So let's just stop the playback. You can see by the here by the noise, and this thing keeps spinning. So there's in the pause or stop mode, there is friction, continuous friction on the tape, because at this point the tape does not spin, but the head does spin. And apparently this did not damage the tape, I guess. So again, at this point the tape is stationary and the head is spinning. See, and the tape is stationary, but it doesn't damage the tape somehow. Anyhow, a couple of weird things about this old technology. Unfortunately, this machine, and I will recommend you pay attention to this. There are a few things saying, I got image, but I got no sound. These machines, like I say in another video, being the later models, this one, it's a Sony. The companies knew that these machines are going to be used for 1 to 3 years at most, being replaced by DVD. So they put cheap parts in there that just would not last. The video part is good on this one. It lost the sound part no matter what I would try, settings or cables, connection, whatever. So be aware of this. If you want to use one of these just for the fancy part of it, some may no longer work. Okay, thanks for watching.